Hello everyone. I am going to tell you an interesting use of kinematics, 1D kinematics, its basic equations. So what we'll do is we'll calculate the reaction time with whatever tools we have over here. First of all, let me tell you what is reaction time. Let us say you are riding your bicycle or bike or scooty, or you are riding your four-wheeler. You are driving your four-wheeler. A student starts crossing the road. When he starts crossing the road, you suddenly notice him and apply your brakes. When you apply your brakes, the car stops after going some distance. Now, this is a two-step process. Stopping the car or a bike or a bicycle is a two-step process. The first step is your eyes receive a signal that somebody is crossing the road. They pass that signal to the brain. Brain then sends a command to your hands so that they should apply the brake. This is the first step. This step, it involves the electrical signal transmission from your eyes to your brain and then to your hands. This is the first step. The time that it takes for this step to happen is called as reaction time. Once you apply your brakes, car or bike or whatever vehicle is there, it moves certain distance ahead. That depends on how powerful the brakes are. So that step has nothing to do with the human being. It has something to do with the design of the vehicle. But the first step has something to do with our capability of perceiving something and reacting to that. And that is why it is called as reaction time. Okay. So, reaction time is usually, for a normal human being, it is usually in milliseconds. Now, to measure a time in milliseconds, we'll need a special watch, special stopwatch, which measures time in milliseconds. Now, we currently don't have such arrangement to have a clock in which measures time in milliseconds. But we have our physics for our help. What we'll do is, we'll do a small demonstration here. You can do the same kind of experiment in your home. You can call any of your family members, if you are in school, you can call some of your friends and do this experiment for checking the reaction time. So let me call over here my wife. She will act as an assistant for this experiment. Now what I'll do is, I'll hold this scale in hand so that the zero mark of the scale, she will be holding that mark, okay? But she will just be holding her fingers near the scale, but will not be holding the scale actually. Whereas I'm holding the scale, she has hold it on zero mark. When I release the scale, her eyes will notice that I have released the scale. So that is the event that has happened. And she will try to catch hold of the scale. The distance that the scale travels in between, that will help us to give the reaction time. So let us do this experiment now. So she has held it on 25 centimeter mark. So let us note down the first distance. It is 25 centimeter. Let us do this experiment one more time. Now she will hold it on 2 centimeter mark. Let us see. So when she holds it on 2 centimeter mark and then I release it, she caught it at 27 centimeter mark. 2 times is more than enough. Now using this, let me formulate the process of calculating reaction time. So you know that when I was holding the scale in my hand, it had a speed of 0 meters per second because I was holding it. When I just release it, it starts with that 0 meters per second speed. Now consider this scale as an object that is traveling downward under gravity. So what is the initial velocity for that? It is 0 meters per second. What is the acceleration with which it is moving down? Now since the entire motion, this is your scale, and since the entire motion is downward, and the sign convention is in my hands, I can choose downward as positive. You can in fact choose upward as positive and do the same calculations, you'll get the same answer. But let me choose downward positive because that is simpler. No motion of this is going to be upward. So acceleration is plus 10 meters per second square. This is the acceleration due to gravity. It is downward and I have assumed downward positive, so it is going to be positive. Now the displacement that happened between I releasing the scale and she catching it, the distance that it traveled is, average distance is 25 centimeter. Now, the two remaining things are final velocity of the scale when before she caught it and the time that it took. Now, we are not interested in the velocity, but we are interested in time. And this is going to be her reaction time, not my reaction time. This is going to be her reaction time because she noticed it and she caught it. Now, let me formulate the equation. It is S is equal to ut plus half at square. Equation of kinematics, one of the equation of kinematics, which you already know, u is 0, so this term will be 0, plus half into acceleration is 10. I taken an approximate value, so whatever reaction time you will get, that will be approximate one, into t square, that is equal to s, which is 25 centimeter. If I convert it to meter, because everything else is in SI units, so let me convert it to meter, it is 0.25 meter. You refer your table of power of 10 for doing this conversion. Now, that gives me 0.25 over 5, that is equal to t square. So, this will be 0.05, that is equal to t square. Now, a quick calculation we will do for finding t. I will be using my calculator for doing that. So, after a quick calculation using a calculator, it gave me 0.22 seconds as a reaction time. If you want to get a clearer idea of this, you can convert it to milliseconds. So, that gives me 220 milliseconds. Again, for this conversion, you can refer the table of power of 10. Now, this is an approximate value, of course, because I have made so many assumptions. This 10 meter per second square is an approximate value. Then your fingers are thick, so wherever on whichever mark you hold those fingers, that is not clear whether it is 25 centimeter or 24 or 26. So that much plus or minus 1 centimeter, tolerance is there. So with all those errors involved in the calculation, still this is a good idea about the reaction time of a person. It is in milliseconds, it is 220 milliseconds. Your friend or your mother, your father, they'll be having different reaction times. So it is an interesting experiment that you can do at your home and find your own or your relatives or your friends' reaction times. Okay, thank you.